Wanted to drop a video today about BRRR, Refurb, Refinance, and I'll explain what that is and why we do it, and then maybe some tips for how to secure BRRR, Refurb, Refinance in Liverpool. So when we started our property journey, we were always really keen to just make sure that we did single buy to lets, keep it as simple as possible, just one tenant, one AST, and very little input from us once the tenancy is being set up. Tenants who probably don't cause us that much hassle in the grand scheme of things, who are good tenants who want to make the house their home. So BRRR, Refurb, Refinance was something that we went and learned an awful lot about, because obviously the money runs out after a while. So you've got a certain pot of cash, you want to buy some properties, you can use that as a deposit and put a mortgage on these properties to leverage your cash, but ultimately that cash is going to run out at some point. So BRRR, Refurb, Refinance is something that we've been doing and found it really quite successful, because what that means is you're buying a property in a poor state of repair, needs a lot of upgrading usually. You can buy for a good price, you can then do the refurbishment, so you can get your team to do it, you can spend whatever you want to spend on the refurbishment. Obviously it needs to be a fairly sensible refurbishment, because the whole point of this is to then refinance the property at the end at a much higher value than what you actually spent on the property. So you're forcing capital appreciation, because what you've done is add some value to that property. So that's something that we've been really focused on, and single buy to lets, BRRR, Refurb, Refinance, and then run it as a single buy to let. That's our preferred strategy. So it's not an overnight really quick fix. You know, anybody that says, you know, you can get in and get out really, really quickly, this isn't always the case with BRRR, Refurb, Refinance, because it can take you a very long time to actually find the property in the first place, because Liverpool particularly is getting a really hot market and lots of people are looking for the same thing. So the competition is high and the sellers are basically in a bit of a seller's market. So people are asking too much for their properties, too much for what we would like to buy them for sometimes, and it can take a long time to find the deal. Then obviously we need to finance it, and then we need to do the refurbishment, and then we're not always refinancing out within 6 months. You can do that, you can find some lenders that will allow you to put a mortgage on the property as soon as the refurbishment is finished and your tenant is in place, and sometimes you can do that within 6 months, but the rates aren't always as attractive as if you waited after the 6 months. So some lenders' criteria say that what you actually have to do is own the property for 6 months before they will let you put a mortgage on it. So that's something to really, really understand and get your head around, and probably time, not in today's video, but maybe for another video. So finance is crucial. You need to understand how much you have to buy, how much you can play with in terms of refurbishment, and then what your exit strategy is on the mortgage. And then that allows you to keep your budgets really tight, and you can keep the time frames, and then you can pull the money back out, and then you can do the same thing again. You can basically recycle that cash. So that's what we've been focusing on. And we do that, I would like to say, very successfully. We produce very beautiful homes for people, and our tenants appear to be very happy, so we're happy, they're happy, and obviously we've got really sensible deals on our mortgages and things. So we're not we're not flipping, we're not creating big chunks of cash every 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, whatever other people are doing, and we're not running HMOs and we're not running SA. We are simply fixed on single buy to lets. BRRR, Refurb, Refinance is the preferred strategy. Sometimes we're just buying a mortgage. So I had a one-to-one with one of my good investors a couple of days ago, and he's doing a similar thing. He's basically focused on single buy to lets, and what he's been doing so far is just going and viewing and looking for things on the market and then haggling over the price and trying to negotiate down that price. Now the properties he's bought so far in Liverpool do need a little bit of work, and he's already got a team in place, so he's able to do some refurbishment, and he's buying the properties for cash and he's doing the refurbishment, and then he's going to exit onto a mortgage. Now what he's achieved so far is a really sensible return on his investment. He's not necessarily going to get all of his money back out. He's probably not going to get a huge chunk of his money back out, to be perfectly honest. But what he has definitely bought are good houses in good areas that will rent well to long-term tenants who want to stay for a long time. So that idea of fairly passive income, that's about as passive as you'll get it. And obviously he'll still be using a managing agent to manage properties for him. So one of the questions that he asked me at the end, and then he's followed up with an email this week, is what are the key postcodes for BRRR, Refurb, Refinance in Liverpool? And I seen the email last night, and it's a really simple answer. So where do you do BRRR, Refurb, Refinance in Liverpool? What's the secret? Where's the postcodes? Where's the area? So first of all, BRRR, Refurb, Refinance works anywhere in any city where you can achieve the outcome that you want. So if you backtrack and kind of, if you want to create it like a bit of a formula, it's really simple to work out. So at the end, your exit strategy is a mortgage, and you are probably likely to be geared at 75% loan to value. So you would have a 25% deposit in your house, 75% mortgage. So what you need to be able to create is you need to find a property that you can buy for a good enough, low enough price that you can then do the refurbishment on, which you probably know roughly what the figures are. If you know anything about property and refurbishment and you know enough tradespeople who can give you a good quote, you can usually guess what, a pretty good guess of what that figure is going to be for the refurbishment. And then you need to make sure that you can exit at, you're going to refinance property at a high enough value to allow your 75% that you're going to pull back out of that deal to kind of cover the purchase price and the refurb. And if you're really, really good at the strategy, you'll pull out your purchase price, your refurb, and then a little bit of money for your back pocket, which is what we've done on a few properties. So it's not a secret area. It's not a secret postcode. I'm not going to say to you, oh, you need to go to this road and this is where you buy the house and this is where it will always work. The secret is actually in finding the property for the right price in the first place. So in terms of your formula, you need to buy a house for a certain price. You need to spend a certain amount of money on refurbishment, and then you need it to value up at a certain price. So let's start at the end and work backwards. So if you look in certain postcodes in Liverpool where you can buy, say, a two-bed terrace, and you're gonna do a complete refurbishment on that property, so you're gonna give it a new kitchen, a new bathroom, you're gonna decorate it throughout, not structural stuff or anything major, no real roof issues or that, but you might wanna fix up the gutters and tidy up the garden and do the internal decor and nice floors and things. So a two-bed terrace refurbishment is probably gonna set you back about £12,000 to £14,000 to do a really good refurbishment. And it's important that you do a good refurbishment, because what's going to happen is you're going to have tenants who move in, and if it's a good refurbishment, you're not going to hear from them in terms of maintenance, which is fantastic. So going forward for the next 3 years, 5 years, you're probably not going to have any real issues in terms of maintenance. So your two-bed terrace needs to be bought for a certain figure. You're going to spend about 12 to 14 on the refurb, and then you need to exit at such a high value that allows you to pull that money back out. So if you go and find a two-bed terrace on a side road off like county roads off L4, for example, the final done up value of those properties is only around about £55,000. It might be 60, but it's unlikely to go much higher than that. A refinance, when a value comes out, that's the maximum they're going to be financed, they're going to value those properties at. So if you work that backwards, what's 75% of that? So let's keep the figure simple. If it's a £60,000 valuation at the end, 75% of that is £45,000. So that's what you can pull out of that deal. So if you're going to be spending 12 to 14,000 on your refurb, that's 45,000, take away 12 or take away 14. Okay, so we're down to about 31,000, 33,000. That's what you need to be buying the property for. Some people also want to pull out their legal fees, their stamp duty, their solicitors' costs, their brokers' costs, all those kinds of extra things. And I think in Liverpool, that's absolutely not common. It's not something you will find a lot of. We can do it now and again. It's not on every single property at all. We just do it every now and again on a really good property. But that's because we're here, we know the market, we can act a little bit more quickly. We've also got our own trades that probably cost us far less than your trades would if you're working from afar. So you're not going to be able to find those houses for 30,000, 31,000, 33,000 because they're just not available on Rightmove. Somebody will have found them, somebody will have bought them, a local builder will have bought them, a local landlord will have bought them already, but you're not going to find those on Rightmove. Anything that comes to market, guys, is a 30 in the auctions, undoubtedly goes for at least 40, because the low guy price kind of forces people into the auctions. And then the alternative to that is, yeah, it's guides as a 30, yeah, it sells for 30, but there's a reason for it. So there might be a regulated tenancy in place, you can't evict the tenant, and therefore you can't do the BRRR strategy. It might be that there's real structural issues with the property, the property's falling down, and actually your £12,000 refurbishment is not £12,000 anymore, it's suddenly £25,000. So what you're looking for is an area where the property is going to value up high enough at the end to give you enough leeway to pull out the refurbishment costs, because the refurbishment costs plus your, obviously plus your purchase price, the refurbishment costs are the same across the city. Our builders don't say, well, it's 12 grand if you're buying an L4 and it's 18 grand if you're buying in L6, for example. So the refurbishment, get clear on what your figures are on a refurb, and don't be cheating, don't be tight, don't be cutting corners because that won't get you the end valuation. But spend 12,000 to 14,000 on a two-bed house, spend 16,000 to 18,000 on a three-bed house, do a good enough refurb, and then get it to refinance up at the higher value. So I think really your starting point needs to be areas where you can buy a house that is going to refinance at the end value at about 80,000 minimum. Because if you take 75% of 80,000, work that back, that's 60,000. So you can pull 60,000 out of the deal after the refinance. So that means your refurb costs 12,000, 14,000 off 60, 46, 48. You probably can buy a two bedroom house somewhere for 46, 48,000. And it probably will value up at about 80,000 or so. 80,000 might be a bit tight as well. So if you're new to Liverpool, you don't know the areas really well, where are you going to do buy, refurb, refinance? Personally, I'd be watching the market. I'd be looking on Rightmove. I'd be getting to really understand the postcodes where A, I can find a house that will, in its done up state, refinance or sell on at between £80,000 to £100,000. Three beds ideally. £80,000 to £100,000 final value. And then I'd find out what my refurb costs are likely to be on that size of project, get in touch with a really good builder, contact two or three builders, get an idea for what they can do for £18,000 in a house, ask them really clearly, are you going to be able to add value to a house for that figure? And then work it back to find out what your purchase price needs to be. And that's where you need to start your focus. So there's no secret postcode, there's no secret area, there's not a little street that Vicky goes and buys houses in and does the buy, refurb, refinance, and that's her little goldmine area. Liverpool is my goldmine area, and what we are doing is buying houses for the right price in the first place. So the right price, somewhere we know we can tenant it, and somewhere we know that the final done up value, the final refinance figure, is high enough to allow us to pull out a significant chunk of our cash. In terms of your expectations, don't expect that you will pull out every single penny. It's just not happening very much. They're rare, they are very, very rare, and you will spend 12 months, 18 months looking for that deal and wasting a huge amount of time, in which time the market will have changed and you could have benefited from rent. Personally, I think you're doing really well if you pull out all of your refurbishment costs. So if you're able to pull out your purchase price plus purchase price plus about 75% of your refurbishment costs, you're doing really, really well. If you pull out all of your refurbishment costs, you're doing exceptionally well. And there are very few people who are also pulling out their legals, stamp duty, sourcing fees, and all those extra things as well. Hope that was useful. Please drop me a comment below if you think it was. I really want to remind myself to do more videos because I love talking and I love talking to you guys. So drop me a comment below if you think it was useful and tell me what you'd like to hear more about. Okay, see you all soon. Have a good week.